Hey, good morning, afternoon, Math One. In the background, you might hear a vacuum. Living room being vacuumed now, so hey, it is what it is. Anyway, 5.3 features of functions. We're going to look at a question involving an exponential function. We're going to graph that. It's number 2, f of x equals 3 times 4 raised to the x power. Now we're going to state the domain of the function. So let's graph this exponential. Let's first start off by creating a table of values. So I'm going to let x be negative 1. And so by looking at the work involved in that, it would be 3 times 4 raised to the negative 1 power. That negative 1 tells 4 to be, the reciprocal of that would be 1/4, so it would be 3 times 1/4 to the first power, and so the output would be 3/4. Let's try 0, and looking at the value here would be 3 times 4 to the 0 power. 4 to the 0 power is 1, so this would be 3 times 1, which is just 3. And I think I'm going to clean this up a little bit. And that's my output there. So let me highlight some of my outputs here. So this is the output 3/4 when x is negative 1. The output of 3 when x is 0. And then let's try a couple more. Let's try 1. Input of 1. So it's 3 times 4 to the first power, which is 12. And if we try 2, it would be 3 times 4 to the second power, and 4 times 4 is 16, and 16 times 3 is 38. Is that right? Or 48. Yeah, 48. All right, so let's highlight that again. So let's graph this. So I'm going to take the information. I'm going to set this up as best as I can using the right table of values and also the proper x and y axis scaling. And I'm going to choose here and here. Okay, so great. This is y, this is x. And I will choose my scaling here to be negative 1, 1, 2, and 3. And then for my y scaling, I'm going to choose 2, 4, 6, 8, and 12 would be up here somewhere, 12. So, now, let's start plotting some points. When my x value is negative 1, the y value is 3/4. And so 3/4 would be about right here somewhere. And when my x value is 0, the y value is 3. So 0, 3 would be here. And when my x value is 1, my y value is 12, which is way up here. And then when my x value is 2, my y value is 48, it's not going to fit. So the graph looks something like this. So that's just a portion of the graph. Now, what is the domain of this function? Well, I know that I can continue to pick other negative numbers, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, And so there should be an arrow here, which means that my domain is all numbers, all real numbers. So my domain would be all real numbers. If you've never seen this before, that R with two vertical lines means real. And then, of course, the hashtag is numbers. So all real numbers using interval notation. That would be another way of representing all real numbers. So I hope that helped. Like I always say, study hard and learn a lot. And we'll see you soon. Bye.